VHS, DVD, openings and closings, plus kinetic motion, toy music, videos, puppet show remakes and collection, updates starring me, Chase Ace 51272.0. Hey there YouTube, and welcome to the second part of my general Baby Einstein collection update video. Now, as you all can see, I've got new VHSs, I've got new DVDs, and at the end of the video, I will show you all two rare toys that I've got as well. So, without any further ado, let's go ahead and go straight into the collection. Here we go! Alright, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and cut to the chase. Or, cut to the Chase Ace. Ba-dum-bum. Alright, anyway, with jokes aside, I've got to start my second copy of the Baby Mozart 2002 VHS. This time the CD is actually included, like most of my VHSs up to this point do not. Anyway, this is the front. Here is the back. The left side. The right side. The top. And here is the page and the CD, which is included inside. Now, you can see that there's some visible signs of damage and other scratches, which honestly doesn't bother me anyway because I've already got the soundtrack downloaded. Anyway, here is the actual cover. The light, I know, is kind of reflecting off of the CD. And now the most important part is the VHS itself, with the ink label, as you can see here, and the print date on that is September 5th, 2002. Okay, and the second VHS I have for you is a second copy of the Baby Bach 2002 VHS. This time the bonus CD is included as well. This is the front, the back, the left side, the right side, the top. And here is the inside. Once again, the bonus CD is included. Luckily, this one doesn't have as much damage and scratches like the last one did. But honestly, it doesn't bother me either. Just because, like, most of the Baby Einstein soundtrack is already in my phone. So this is the CD cover, as you can see here. And now, the VHS tape itself. We've got the ink label, Baby Bach, Walt Disney Home Entertainment, and the print date is September 4th, 2002. Okay, now for this next one, I'm not exactly sure how rare this one is, but I do know that it's a second copy of mine that I own now. This is the Baby Shakespeare late 2001 VHS, with the bonus CD tab, but not the actual CD itself. So, this is the front. Here is the back, the left side, the right side, the top, and here is the page. Once again, the bonus CD is not included with this tape specifically. And here is a booklet that came with the tape as well. And the VHS, it has big reels, a sticker label, but no print date included. Which was a little weird to me as well. Okay, now for this VHS, this one is another one I'm not exactly sure on how rare it is, but this is the first edition of the Baby Van Gogh 2000 VHS. Now, before I continue showing off the details to this VHS, I'd like to take a minute to do some compare and contrasting. You'll notice on your screen the two 2000 VHSs and the one 2002 VHS from Baby Van Gogh. The notable difference on all three covers is the size and text of Baby Van Gogh. The first one is the very first edition of Baby Van Gogh, and the difference in the video itself is the warning screen opening and the purple music video with a different version of Bolero. The other two are the traditional Bolero music videos and the warning screen opening. Alright, now on to the details. This is the front. Here is the back. The left side. The right side. The top. Here is the page. And another notable difference on the first edition is the sticker label with the FHE logo. And the print date on that is July 17th of 2000. Alright, so now we're going to go ahead and move on to the DVDs that I have in this collection. And a quick spoiler warning, they're all FHE DVDs. The first one is the Baby Mozart 2000 DVD. Here is the front. The back. The left side. And here is the inside with the Baby Mozart Parents Guide and the DVD itself with the FHE logo, Baby Mozart DVD video. Alrighty, and here is the next DVD I have for you all. This one is the Baby Bach 2000 DVD. This is the front, the back, the left side, and here is the inside. Once again with the Parents Guide and the DVD with the Baby Bach logo and FHE logo. Alright, and now for this last DVD, I've been getting comments of people asking, if not begging me, to get this one. And boy, I'm telling you, this one was not easy to find at all. This is the Baby Doolittle Neighborhood Animals 2001 DVD. So this is the front. Here's the back. The left side. And here's the inside, and here we got another parents guide and the Neighborhood Animals logo, FHE logo, DVD video logo. Alright, these next two items that I have are super rare, they're super cool, and I personally cannot be any happier to have found these items, because I personally grew up with these two, and I'm hoping that you all find that they're super cool as well. The first one that I have is the Baby Webster flashcards set. This is the front. Here's the back. The left side. The right side. The top. And here is all the cards. The first one you'll see, it's a tutorial on how to use them and like a parent's guide. And here's the back side. Alright, and now I've organized all these cards in order of the electronic version that you'll see in the Einstein, Mozart, and Bach DVD versions. Alright, now the second super rare, super cool item that I want you all to see is, of course, another one that I ended up growing up with personally. It's the Baby Doolittle flashcard set. Here is the front. The back. The left side, the right side, the top, and here are the cards. For some reason, it came with a booklet as opposed to a parent's guide. This is a cardboard cutout of the cards, and here are the cards themselves, which I've once again rearranged them from the digital versions of Neighborhood Animals and World Animals. Alright, these next three toys I have are super rare, they're super cool, and I just can't express in other words how cool these items are. So if you're ready, let's go ahead and take a look. The first toy I have for you all is the Gemini Millennium Mobile toy as seen in the 2004 version of Baby Mozart. Now, I'm personally not too big of a fan of the 2004 versions. However, this toy is probably the closest thing to the Mini Orbiter that I'll get. Now, I say that because when I first watched Baby Mozart, the Mini Orbiter looked so cool to me, so therapeutic, that I really wanted to have that toy. But I know nowadays it's really hard to find that exact toy. So at this time, this is probably the closest thing I'll get, and I'm happy with it either way. It's so cool. Once again, very therapeutic. Just looking at it go, and I'm really glad to have it. Okay, and here is the box for the Kinetic Mobile toy. Now, this is the front. It says Millennium Mobile on the front, and this one says Gemini. I'm not sure why it has two separate names, but hey, I'm just going to go along with it. There's another one, the Venus. That's seen in the 2004 version of Baby Van Gogh, by the way. And I know the box has a pretty fair condition, for lack of a better word, but it doesn't bother me because as long as the toy itself is fine, I'm totally cool with it. Okay, so this next toy I have is another one that I've been wanting to get for such a long time, especially watching Baby Mozart as a kid. This is the Playful Circus Seals toy from Da Yang Toys, or otherwise known as DY Toy. Now, the thing about this toy I really like, the seals go up the staircase with the there's the on switch at the bottom. However, after getting this toy and realizing how annoying the squeaking sound gets, it gets pretty annoying after a while. However, I do like the fact that it wasn't Baby Mozart. It just looks so satisfying seeing the seals go down despite how annoying the squeaking is. And I know it starts off slow, I don't know if you noticed, but like it started off pretty slow at the beginning. And the longer it continues to run, the faster the seals go and the faster the squeaking sound and the stairs go. Now, I'm just kind of moving this around, showing it at a different angle so that you guys can have a better look on like where the seals go and everything. Like the footage that like Baby Mozart shows, like I'm kind of like going all over. Like this is lazy Susan, for lack of a better term, because I'm just moving this by hand, of course. It does look really cool. The squeaking sound is unbearable to me, but despite that, it's a really cool toy, and I'm really glad to have it. It's so cool. The seal is going down like that on the slide. It's, I don't know, something about it as a kid just made me want to get it so bad. It was so cool watching the seals go down automatically like that with the wheels on the bottom of the seals. I don't know, I just can't properly describe how cool it is to get the toy that I wanted for so long. It's just so cool. Good thing that squeaking sound's over with. Okay, now I've saved the best toy for last. It's another Baby Mozart toy. I grew up with it as a kid. I mentioned it in a previous video. I had a cousin who grew up with this same toy. And I'm hoping you guys will be just as excited to see it as I am to have it. If you're ready, let's see what it is. It's the Castle Pounder toy by Chica, and as some call it, Castelinho, which is Portuguese for little castle. Now, what makes this toy so unique to me personally is that not only has it been shown in Baby Mozart, it has the four colorful towers, green, blue, red, and yellow, and you get the colorful balls that you can put in each tower as well, and like just hitting them with the mallet for some reason gives you the most satisfying feeling, especially when watching the video as a kid. So as you can see, I got the balls in my hand, and I'll put them in each of their designated towers in the Baby Mozart style. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and grab the mallet that's on the side of the castle, and I've already put the door in a lock position, and this is the exact colors that were used in the video, so I'm going to go ahead and give a demonstration to show you all how it's done. When I first got the toy, I was confused on why the horse on the bottom left corner was there. Until when I saw the blue handle on the side, I knew it was probably the best toy. Alright, so now I'm gonna unlock the door, like how they show in Baby Mozart, and just give a little demonstration. I'm not going to use the mallet just because I just want to give a demonstration. Just the green ball will be fine. Unfortunately with my toys sometimes, the ball will get stuck in the door and I have to get another one down to push it out. But either way, I still like the fact that I get to use the mallet to hit the colorful balls out of their towers. It was a cool toy growing up as a kid. Alright, I hope y'all enjoyed my general collection update video of Baby Einstein items. However, before I go, I'd like to once again apologize for not having uploaded videos within the past few months, within the past year, whatever you want to say. I really don't have a good excuse other than the fact that since I'm getting older now, I have a lot more personal responsibilities to deal with in my life. But I'm hoping within the coming future, I could at least upload 1 to 2 videos a month for you. It's not going to be easy for me because of my schedule and everything, but I can at least try to the best of my ability to make more content for you. I can't make any promises, but I will try to the best of my ability, like I said. If you all would like to see part 1 of this video, you can click on the link on the screen there, and you can also, while you're at it, click on the subscribe button in order to show your support. It would definitely be most appreciated. Until then, I will see you all later.